So I have been using this Garmin Tactics Delta Solar for around a month now. I have made an unboxing first look setup video. Of course, I can link it down below if you want to check that out as well. So it has been on my wrist ever since I got it, except for the two times that I have charged the watch. So that's the only occasion where I actually have removed it. So it's been with me running, hiking, showering, you know, you name it. I have had this watch with me for the last month or so. So let's just take a look at the overall condition. I definitely have banged this watch into several things throughout the month, and I think it actually still looks quite nice. This is of course the Solar version, but I think it's identical in terms of the glass and otherwise aesthetics as the normal Tactics Delta without the Solar. So anyways, let's just wipe the screen down a little bit here and have a closer look at the Sapphire screen and see if it's still scratch-free. And yeah, definitely scratch-free, looks pretty much like it was new. And like I said, I have actually slammed it in or danged it into several things throughout the times I've had it. I tend to take pretty good care of my watch, but this is a rather big watch and it also sticks out a little bit from the wrist, of course. And I, like I said, have had it on pretty much the entire time. Only when I charged it, I have removed it from my wrist. So yeah, it kind of looks a little gross. You can see down here, it does accumulate some kind of gunk, sweat or water or whatever. I have been running in the rain and so definitely have been accumulating some dust and some gunk here on the watch itself. But else, it looks pretty much brand new. Also on the watch case itself, which is some kind of polymer or plastic, it still looks brand new. I have no dings or scratches or anything on the watch case at all, and the bezel as well looks quite like it was new, which is kind of impressive because I have definitely scratched it into my wall several times. But you can see some stuff do accumulate down there with the watch band where it connects to the watch. Otherwise, the button still feels and looks brand new. Haven't had any wear on those as of yet, but this is also just a month of usage. But you can see on the bottom side here, it doesn't really look all that delicious. And I do apologize for this. I just wanted to show you the real watch here, or how it looked real without me actually wiping it down for this video. So you can, yeah, kind of see what kind of stuff accumulates on the back of the watch there. So sweat and skin and so on. This is definitely not the most comfortable watch band I have been using, but after a week or so, I did get used to it. But anyways, you can see the charging port there. It does have some kind of gunk and sweat and stuff in there, so you need to clean it from time to time. But most of the time, it works without any issues, but a lot of stuff can accumulate down there. But like I said, this watch band there, even though I really like the look of it, and it is a very durable watch band, it is very stiff, very thick, and not flexible at all in terms of actually stretching or anything like that. You can see it does have flex here in the link itself, so it can kind of flex in either direction. But you can see here this side of the watch band has direct contact to the skin. And yeah, this is my skin that has just been scratched off wearing this watch. It does move around a little bit on my wrist because it is a big watch, even though I wear it relatively tight to my wrist, and I do also wear it a little higher on my wrist. But you can see there where the watch band have actually met my wrist. Yeah, it's kind of worn off my skin there, and it's actually exactly where, yeah, you can see the skin on the watch band itself is exactly where it has been on my wrist. And you can kind of see just a little dent in my wrist there where the little watch strap holder had actually been resting. So it wasn't as comfortable as I thought, coming from the sports band on my Apple Watch, which is a super, super comfortable watch band. And it also smells a little bit after a month of usage, running pretty much every day, or at least doing some kind of activities pretty much every day, which has brought me to sweat. And the watch band definitely do smell. So you kind of need to wash this regularly and, of course, use it in shower and so on to get this watch band clean. But you can see right there, it has definitely worn off my wrist a little bit. And there is also a little dent there in my armrest where the pulse oximeter sensor have kind of been resting. But yeah, definitely have worn off some of my skin off, and that's a little unfortunate. The first week it was not the most comfortable watch band, but after a week or so, I didn't really notice it on my wrist anymore. And I haven't really felt this on my wrist. It doesn't like hurt or anything, but it has definitely worn off some skin there. The other side of the watch band still looks pretty decent. Of course, have some sweat and water and some kind of dust and gunk on there as well. And this is a watch band you need to clean regularly if you definitely want to have it, of course, nice and clean. Also, the watch band does accumulate a lot of, or hold a lot of water and sweat. It takes some time for the watch band to actually dry out. So if it has been wet, you should probably consider taking it off unless you really want to, you know, wear your skin down like I have done here. Because if your skin gets wet, it's easier for it to actually break. And this watch band is very, yeah, tough on your skin. But it is a very durable watch band. I really like the look of it. And you can see the clamp there still looks pretty good. There are some micro scratches on it. But this is also a very exposed part. You know, every time I rest my wrist down, it's definitely touching the table and other stuff you are resting your wrist on. But still, it looks pretty nice, I think, after a month or so. And I said, aesthetically, I really like this watch band, so I'm not going to change it out. I have been looking for the looking at the Enduro watch band, which kind of resembles the sports band from Apple, but maybe in the future I will try that out. But in terms of using the watch itself, I've had no issues, no shutdown, no problems at any sort, other than maybe GPS not being the most accurate and not the fastest at getting the GPS fix sometimes. But most times it actually is pretty fast, and within a few seconds I am ready to go off. One thing still, I think Garmin watches not the fastest when it comes to mapping capabilities, but we'll take a look at that a little bit later here. But in terms of the overall user interface, it is fast and pretty snappy. Had no issues. Definitely do feel a little dated in terms of its menu structure and navigation. But the physical control of having physical buttons is pretty nice to have, I think. I hope, though, Garmin will maybe look at something like a digital crown or maybe some touch interface. Something that you can navigate the system a little more easily, at least some parts. If you want to set timers, for instance, you can just maybe touch the screen and set the timers. But anyways, the only real issue I have is mapping. And that's when I'm zooming in and out and want to go up and down in the mapping. You can see here zooming in and out. Takes quite some time. Actually, this is rather fast. If there is more stuff on the map, it will take quite a bit longer. But it's not the fastest in terms of mapping capabilities. Actually, quite usable. I use it all the time when I'm going on one-day hikes and so on, just to let me know where I am and how I can get back to starting position quickly as possible, or easily as possible. And I kind of set my route as I am going on, because it does have a pretty accurate topo map on there. But you can see when I'm actually wanting to switch or look at, example, north, and I want to turn the watch in the direction of north, you can see it does take quite some time to actually orientate the screen to the way I am actually looking at, or the way I've actually turned the watch there. So the compass feature of the mapping here, not the fastest, and that's really the only issue I really have with the mapping capabilities. Coming from an Apple Watch, you know, if you have some topo maps, like some apps have topo maps on there, it is just immediate when you like turn your body and wanted to point your watch at a certain point, it just turns immediately, like on your smartphones and so on. So it definitely does feel a little slow here, but overall, other places in the menu structure, for instance, if you're just going for a run here, switching between the different menus there or data screens, it feels fast and snappy enough. And I've had no issues with the menu structure or system at all. And I also bought it kind of late, so I believe all of the bugs and so on have been ironed out. One slight issue I have, though, is it can take some time to actually synchronize the watch, as you can see here. Definitely not the fastest at synchronizing over Bluetooth. This is a Samsung S21 Ultra, so it's a rather new phone. It does have Bluetooth 5.2, but I believe the watch only have 5.0. But it can take some time. And the other issue with the solar, I'm not really sure it's worth it in terms of what the extra cost. But you can go in and see, of course, how much solar you have had throughout the days. on this scale here. I believe the 100% is 50,000 lux, but it doesn't really tell you how much battery life you have actually accumulated. For instance, a day like this, where I have been in the sun quite a lot, it doesn't really tell me, is this like 30 seconds more battery life, 1 minute? It would be nice to have some kind of estimate on how much battery life you've actually accumulated when you're in the sun. Just let you know how many minutes, for instance, or seconds, or whatever kind of battery life you could have, you have accumulated with the sun energy you have exposed this watch. It would be pretty nice. I don't know if it's too advanced to do something like that. And the other thing is the GPS accuracy. You can see I'm running on the green trail here, not on the road. And it definitely doesn't track me all that great all the time, which is a little unfortunate. I believe my Fenix 5X Plus was a little bit better, but this one has a newer GPS. But you can see there I'm running on the green trail, the one closest to the lake, and still I am pretty off on the GPS accuracy there. And as well up here, I'm running on the green trail. There's actually no trail where the GPS had plotted my run there. But this is also kind of low ground level, so I'm near a lake and very low, and there's a lot of trees and so on, so it's a kind of a hard environment. But still, it is not the most accurate. And you can see also here, it kind of loses it a little bit there. I'm running on the green trails. As again, I have had it on GPS plus GLONASS, which is what I have experienced is to be the best in Northern Europe where I live. I don't have the 3D distance or 3D speed turned on. That should be able to help a little bit, so I might turn that on in the future. But I have set it to register my data every second. Out of the box, it does come set to smart. That's even worse than 1 second or each second. So I keep it at each second, and it does help a little bit. But as you can see, it's definitely not perfect. And that's a little unfortunate, but you do get quite a bit better battery life with this generation compared to the Fenix 5 series. So, of course, there is a worthy trade-off there, in my opinion. And in terms of getting into shape, my shape is pretty bad still. My age, or Condi age, is 49. I am 40 in real life, but this watch has actually helped me get up to 39. I started out at 38, and I do use the automatic programs that the watch create for me, or Garmin create for me. And it actually works quite nice getting into shape, focusing on lower and higher aerobic exercises. And in terms of sleep data, is also very important to me, and tend to not get the best sleep. Like 1 hour of deep sleep is not really enough, and that's always my issue, getting enough deep sleep. So it's also nice to actually go in and track my sleep, see how much sleep I've gotten throughout the day, if I feel like tired or not have energy enough to do some certain exercises and so on. I can kind of see that I haven't had enough sleep, and that kind of give me a reason. It's not because I'm just lazy, it's just, yeah, need some more sleep. And of course the stress and the body battery, I use that quite a lot as well. Today I have had kind of a resting day. And in terms of music, for me, I wish that YouTube music were a thing on this watch. I don't really plan to subscribe to another the streaming service. YouTube Music is what I use, because I have a YouTube Premium subscription, and that's included with that kind of subscription there. So as of now, still only Spotify, Amazon Music, and Deezer, and some other music suppliers there I don't really know too much about, like Runtastic, My Music, and so on. So that's kind of one thing I hope for in the future. But overall, it's held up quite nice. I really like this watch. I definitely do not plan to switch it out anytime soon. I hope it can help me get back into shape. I just lost a lot of weight, so now I want to get back into shape and, yeah, just get a better VO2 max. And this watch has definitely helped me out with that, making some exercises for me to do in terms of running. And it definitely helps me out quite a bit. So yeah, I highly recommend. I'm not really sure I would go for the solar version. If you really want it, of course, go for it. But you can save a lot of money just getting the Tactics Delta without the solar. I'm not really sure it actually provides a lot of battery improvements. But it is, I feel like, quite nice to see how much sun I've gotten through the day. I did get too much sun last week, where I had a few days where I couldn't really do much. I got too dehydrated, and I could kind of track it on the watch there and see, yeah, I did get a little too much sun. So something you can just be aware of course, if you get too much sun much sun exposure, which is the main reason why I got it. And also was a little bit curious to see if it actually did have any benefits in terms of battery life. But I feel it doesn't really. For me, around 10 days of use with smartwatch, always connected to my phone, and I get notifications, and I do run pretty much every day. I do some kind of GPS activity pretty much every day for at least 30 minutes. So 10 days, it's what I'm getting out of this watch here, which is definitely pretty nice. So yeah, highly recommend it. Of course, I can share some affiliate link down in the description below if you are interested. But that's pretty much it for this video. I hope to see you again in a future one. Until then, take care.